Yo.
Hey, what
up,
Wydad?
What's up, Sen?
Right. Yo, what up, Tom?
Say
Yo,
something. Get out. I gotta close the thing.
I got one thing. Go. I got one thing to say. Call me Carson. Did nothing wrong.
All right, buddy.
Everyone's counting on me to cheer them up and give them lots of energy. I hope that I can help them study for their test. I'll work hard to support them and always try my best.
All right, guys, it's time to just make this hot take, the definitive send take on this whole Carson thing. People are getting really fucking obnoxious. I'm getting tired of it. I know you guys are getting tired of it. We have people like Defender Noodles out there trying to make everything hyperbolic into a big deal, throwing out bigger words out there than there needs to be. We got people out there, right, saying that it's not a big deal. You know, they could care less about a two-year age gap, right? Then we have other people saying, ah, oh, it's against the law, man. We must enforce the powers that may be or whatever. And I'm just here, you know, and some other people are just here. And we're pulling out the documents that aren't really documents. But I'm going to call them a document because it sounds more professional. But it's actually just something you could get off Google. And it says that people in Carson's state kind of, you know, it's, he's protected. He's protected by the law, ladies and gentlemen. He's protected by the law. So Carson's not really in hot water. And we got people saying that this is immoral, that this is unjust, treating it as if Carson was like some 30-year-old and he was like going after some 17-year-old. But the facts remain the same. It's a two-year age gap. For fuck's sake, Carson still had the name teen in his age. 19. And not even at the 20s. It's the 19. You see the teen? And I love it how the people in the Bloodsport community, oh, we haven't talked about those Spurgs in a while, but the Spurgs in the Bloodsport community want to consider anything with the teen at the end of the name to still be a teen. So why the hell not apply the Spurg logic while we're at it? Even the Spurgs agree that this isn't a big deal. So, bada bing, bada boom, all I'm trying to say is anybody that's trying to go ahead with their new sob story about how Carson, you know, was mean to them or something, or made fun of them or something, because that's the biggest one I found. I found this, you know, what was it, this person, interesting person, made like a fucking 45-minute, 100-hour video or something, I guess, exposing Carson or some shit. I didn't watch that. Fuck off. Fuck if you think I'm gonna watch that. So instead, somebody else watched it. Gave me the gist of it, right? It was painful for them too, and I appreciate them taking the time to go ahead and sit through that torture. But apparently it's just a bunch of boohoo shit. Also, Keemstar said allegedly that he watched it or something in his drama alert, where he said, oh, Carson did terrible things to this person in this timestamp and yada yada yada. I think he timestamped it. I don't know the level of Keemstar's professionalism at this day and age. It's been a little sloppy. Keem's been taking a lot of L's lately, so you never know. But man, he's got dance moves. At least you can say that. I wanna ride on each other alone. Either way, the definitive send take is that nobody cares except for the people that want to hyperbolitize this situation for gain, for 30 seconds of fame or so, right? And as for the quote-unquote victim, I gotta ask a question for the quote-unquote victim in this situation. Why the fuck did you initiate with Carson? If there really is this quote-unquote power dynamic of sorts that's taking effect or whatever, why the fuck did you engage with this man? It almost seems like you're holding the power dynamic by stringing this guy along and making him do whatever you want, making him question himself, right? This is so dumb. This is so stupid. No, I refuse to believe that there was some, you know, power dynamic struggle here. You initiated this conversation, girly. You did. Then you did what an infamous drama YouTuber did by the name of Killer Keemstar, and you know what you did? You jumped the gun with your little accusation. That's another thing. You don't think I forgot about that. Don't think the people forgot about that. You jumped in with your little pedo accusation off the top. That's, yeah, that's a good idea. Jumping the gun, yeah. Carson did nothing wrong, you know? And in terms of exchange of the pictures, And people are like, it's illegal. Well, it's not illegal in Carson State. I mean, we've already gone, you know, over that for one. And two, you know what else is illegal? You know what else is illegal? It's illegal to do it in, you know, when you're like 15 or so, right? But I'm pretty sure a bunch of people, you know, go ahead and do it anyway, right? So, you know, come on. Come on, you guys are really grasping at straws here, lady. You guys are grasping at them straws, and it's so funny, but it's also really fucking annoying, and it's getting on my fucking nerves, right? Y'all are gonna make me go on this whole, you know what, I'm just gonna provide the best defenses for Carson now, because you guys won't shut the hell up, and you guys keep saying, ha ha, victim, no, I don't see any victim here. I don't. I see a woman that was hungry for 30 seconds of fame. I see a woman that's being extremely deceptive, extremely manipulative, taking advantage of somebody that doesn't really have that much charisma, doesn't really have that kind of oomph to push past the haters or the manipulators or the two faces. No offense, Carson, buddy. You need to take some, lessons from the Sen over here. All in all, the final send take. Okay, I said it in Tommy C's stream. Call Me Carson did nothing wrong. And that's the bottom line, because the Sen said so.